A few months ago, I needed to make a desert for a game, kinda behaving like Journey's Sand. This is what I ended up with, and I'm gonna break it down in this video so others can understand and do the same. English subtitles are available. Resources like useful links, screen captures, and timestamps are in the description. First, I imported a landscape done in World Creator to get a realistic base geometry. For the sand color, I used textures taken from the Megascans library. To avoid visible repetition, I put a mask over the landscape to alternate between two textures with different tiling or size. I ended up using the same texture twice, with the second one being rotated 90 degrees. To replicate the grainy feeling of sand, I simply put a blue noise with some calculations in the normal input. I use temporal anti-aliasing in this level. If you don't, you might want to use the upper part of the code to get the same effect. The normal is used to tell the engine which way a surface is facing. Here, instead of a fully blue texture facing straight, the colored noise means the grain are facing in every direction. I then tweak the roughness and specular values to get the grain's reflections visible and feeling right. It is not optimal, and I will return to enhance this once I finish working on the rest of the game. From this point on, I'll talk about everything that was put in World Displacement. World Displacement is a parameter used to add an offset to the position of vertices in the geometry. For example, on this sphere, I can add an offset to the z-axis to all the pink parts, which will move all the points upwards by the desired amount. Here, any white value put into this mask will change the position of points in the model and change the depth. A more detailed mask will result in a more detailed depth. This mask can also change over time, with movement for example. The same idea is used on the landscape to add smaller dunes, wind, and footsteps when things move. The base geometry wasn't detailed enough, so I enabled tessellation to add more vertices to the geometry around my camera. To create the smaller dunes, I looked at the vertex normal node to tell me which way is a point facing in the world. With this information, I could split the landscape between steep and shallow slopes. I then split them again whether they were facing the X or Y axis. The most important part to get it feeling right was adjusting the transitions between each area to achieve a balance between them. I then assigned a different dune pattern to each area. The steep ones have long strips following the slope's direction due to the sun falling from them. Shallow areas have small dunes crossing the slope's direction as the sun accumulates after falling. Here are the nodes I used to split the areas. To emphasize the sun being pushed around by the wind, I added two sine wave masks crossing each other. I then spaced the waves and made them only appear on shallow slopes. Here is the result so far. To make the sun react to the avatar's movement, I used Render Virtual Textures. It allows me to render chosen materials with different colors in the world without them appearing in the landscape. I can then get this color information back and translate it into depth, just like before. If I make this texture visible, here's how it looks. The pink parts will lower the sand, while the light blue will raise it. Here's how to do it. Create a render virtual texture. Only change the content as base color. Create a new blueprint. Search for the RVT volume class. In the details, make sure your RVT is linked. Position the volume around your landscape. Create a material with these nodes. For the texture, I use the red channel for the areas to lower, and the green channel for the areas to raise. I added blue everywhere because the final image looked nicer. Create a new actor blueprint. Add a plane, assign the material to it, disable collisions and shadows. Go to the Virtual Texture tab, choose Virtual Texture only, and select your RVT. in the event graph, and a timeline to make the plane appear, then shrink, and finally disappear. In the landscape material, sample the RVT and calculate how you want the height to change accordingly. Finally, whenever the avatar moves, spawn a plane, and that's it. I also added one plane that is always in front of the avatar when moving, with a different texture. It moves whenever the avatar's feet are in front of the body when walking. When the avatar slides, two trails are created because you can switch your stance. I added a noise mask to the trail to break it up and blend it more. There is also a change in color according to the world displacement. The higher the sand is, the lighter it gets. This effect is emphasized only around the camera to avoid it looking too noisy in the distance. There's a little tiling distortion applied to the lowered areas of the sand. Since this game's art is mainly textures projected on surfaces, emphasizing this distortion was a way to tie the sand in with the rest of the assets. Finally, I tweaked the height fog, placed a simple colored skybox, and added particles of sand in the wind, and also some when the avatar steps or slides. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to this channel as I plan to make others in the near future. The next one will be a 1-minute tutorial on making a cool first-person character with some parkour abilities in Unreal. You can however choose what the video after that will be about. Would you prefer a breakdown of the avatar's controller, or something more light about adding juiciness in a Unity project? If you have any questions about this video or want to chat about game dev related subjects, there is a link to a Discord server in the description. I'll probably do a stream there to answer questions live, if and when people want to. You can also ask them in the comments below. Have a great day.